This week's episode of Gonzo Chinese is brought to you by the Chinese characters...
我是.
Simply defined, it means I am. Yo! Thank you again for tuning in to another episode of Gonzo Chinese. I am one of your hosts, Ben, and I'm always joined by the lovely and very talented...
Hi, 你们好,我是Wendy.
We have a great show in store for you today. For those of you who may be the first Gonzo Chinese video podcast, welcome to the show. Basically, we're just here to teach one Chinese phrase, or we got some other grammar points in that thing, but we want you, at the end of our show, to at least have one phrase that you can walk away with and use in your daily lives. Be it going to the Chinese restaurant and introducing yourself, ordering your favorite General Tso's chicken dish, or maybe even getting that mail order bride on the web. Whatever floats your boat. Today we're going to be teaching you a very simple pattern called I am, or...
Oh, in Chinese it would be 我是.
Now, Wendy, can you give our viewers a brief explanation of that sentence pattern?
Ben, you're such a funny guy. I love to give you an explanation. So, very simply, directly translated, 我, once again, that's 我, is I, or me, and 是 is am, or 是, am. So together is 我是, I am, blah, 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 blah.
Right. That is excellent. That's why we have the talented Wendy over here. To help illustrate our lesson today, we have a special little segment which we call Monterey Park. A little known fact is actually brought to you by the same producers of that wonderful show, The OC. It's just as dramatic and equally as educational. Wendy, can you give us some background on Monterey Park? What's going on?
This week on Monterey Park, we find the cast at a dance club called Dream. They're the whole crew trying to get to know each other a little better. And Rick, as always... he's getting into trouble. That Rick, he's such a troublemaker.
That sounds fascinating. As always, please don't be discouraged after you listen to the whole thing and you don't know what's going on. This is perfectly natural. Just flow with it. You were not going to understand everything at the beginning. If you did, you probably wouldn't be listening to this video podcast. So, listen to it once. We're going to play it again after we play it. Review it. It's going to be subtitles and translations, so don't worry. See how it goes. Things to listen for in today's episode of Monterey Park are many different things. Please listen for 我是, I am. 你是谁, who are you? 朋友, friend. 男朋友, boyfriend. 我要, I want. 一个, a counter for things. 名字, name. 辣妹, hot girl.
Cool. Oh,
hey Rick, 你要去哪儿?
Yeah, 我去找辣妹.
Yeah, I know this is
So, the club was far from empty. It was crowded at the entry. I slide right through like how I do. This girl began to tempt me. She said her name Shaida. I could tell her mama feed her. When they tighten thick, them jeans don't fit. I'm L. Nice to meet you.
What are the means? What's
the Jenny needs to say?
What's the risk?
This
is Jenny's 新朋友。你是谁？
是你男朋友。
那怎么样？
Wow, looks like Rick's gonna get in another fight.
That Rick really likes women. He's always getting into fights. Ugh, I just don't understand men sometimes.
Well, the girl is cute, so I can't blame him.
All you guys are all the same.Let's watch the dialogue one more time, and this time we'll put in the subtitles and translations, and hopefully it will make a little more sense.
Wow, this place is cool.
Wow, there are so many beautiful girls.
Hey, Rick, where are you going?
I'm going to find a hot girl.
Yeah, I know what this is. So, the club was far from empty. It was crowded at the entry. I slide right through like how I do. This girl began to tempt me. She said her name Shaida. I could tell her mama feed her. When they tighten thick, them jeans don't fit. I'm L. Nice to meet you.
你要什么？
我要你的名字。
Jenny,
你是谁？
你是谁？是 Jenny 新朋友。你是谁？
是你男朋友。
那怎么样？
Back to our lesson. Today's key phrase is 我是。Jenny, can you explain a little more or break it down? I mean, how would someone kind of apply this and ask someone a question? You know, what, you know, who are you?
That's actually... That's actually pretty simple. So, 你 is you, so 你, and I am 我. So in our dialogue, we were learning 我是. So the change I am to you are, it is 你是. And so when you put them together, you can put one big phrase together and you get 你是. So we're almost all the way where...we can ask a very, very, important question, which is, who are you? So the final element, or the question word, which changes you are who, would be 谁. So put it all together and you have 你是谁, or 你是谁. Say it with me, 你是谁.
Directly translated,你是谁 is you are who, or literally, who are you?
Exactly. So hopefully the dialogue makes a lot more sense now. It does for me, at least.
我是 Jenny, 你是谁？
我是 Jenny, 你是谁？
Thanks for tuning in. I know we did not cover every single detail in this dialogue, but our whole goal is to try to educate you about certain aspects of the dialogue. Here we were focusing on 我是. There's other vocabulary, and if you want to learn those vocabulary words, we've kind of inserted them at the end of this video to kind of illustrate and educate you guys for those who want to go above and beyond the call of language learning ability or duty.Please watch that in the end. And as always, please, please keep the comments coming to our website or email. Once again, the address is www.gonzochinese.com. There's a message form there. There's an email address, links in that nature over there. We really appreciate the comments, and we want to make this site a lot better than it is right now. So just keep the comments coming, and we'll hopefully try to improve, and hopefully your language will improve in the meantime. So...Thanks again for tuning in, and we'd like to see you again next time. Bye now. Today's bonus lesson is what we call slang in action. This is where we're going to teach you some slang that you may or may not have heard of. Today, we're going to focus on 辣妹. 辣 means spicy. It's the same spicy you would get in your kung pao chicken. You could say 我要辣, which means I want it spicy. Next component of this slang is the Chinese character of 妹. This is the same Chinese character that you would use for younger sister. And in Chinese, I don't know if you know, but normally they designate between older and younger siblings. So if you say 我是妹妹, you would say that I am the younger sister. So, little tidbit. You put these two characters together, la and mei, and what you end up is with a brand new slang term, which is la mei. So directly translated, it means spicy sister, or here in literal terms, we just really mean hot girl. So let's see how this works. Here we have Jennifer Lopez. On most accounts, people say she's not a bad looking woman. So a lot of times we could call her a Jennifer Lopez 是一个辣妹. Here you have to use 一个 to denote one hot woman or one hot girl. So Jennifer Lopez 是一个辣妹. Here we have the famous actress Kelly Hu. We can say Kelly Hu 是一个辣妹. So once again, 辣妹, hot girl. So as you can see, this is a useful phrase. Moving on, we have Oprah Winfrey. Now, Oprah's a little trickier here, so we're going to have to say something different. Here we say Oprah 不是一个辣妹. Here notice we added 不 in front of 是一个. So if you haven't figured it out, 不 means not. So Oprah 不是一个辣妹 means that Oprah unfortunately is not a hot girl. So all you Oprah fans, I'm sorry if you guys disagree with me, but that's just what we decided. Here we have Rosie O'Donnell, another sexy beast. So, if you were to guess, what would you say? We would actually say, Rosie 不是一个辣妹. So, 不 in front of that, again, means not. So hopefully this is pretty useful for you, and you guys can use this in your daily lives.